Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys about the file class in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Welcome back, guys and gals. In this video, we're going to be discussing the file class. Now, a file is an abstract representation of file and directory path names. What we'll be doing in this video is detecting to see if we have a certain file someplace within our computer. So here's an example. Here's my desktop. Please excuse the mess. I'm going to create a new text file on my desktop. So I'm going to go to File, New, Text Document. I'll call this secret underscore message. And I'm going to copy and paste this text document within my project folder. So I'm going to click on my project folder and paste it. So now within my project folder, I have a txt file called secret message. What I'm going to do is just detect to see if I have a file called secretmessage.txt within my project folder to begin with. So we need to create a file object using the file class, but we'll need this import at the top too. So let's create a file object. File, file equals new file. And within the constructor of this file object, we're going to list the file that we're going to associate with this file object. So I'm going to list the name of this file. So within quotes, this title is secret underscore message dot txt. Be sure to include the file extension if it has one. So in order to check to see if a file exists or not, there is a method to do so. So within an if statement, we're going to write file.exists. So if our file exists, if there is a match, we will execute this if statement, and let's just write a message. That file exists. Surprise face. Else, that file won't exist. So within an else statement, we'll display that file doesn't exist. Frowny face. All right, let's try this. And it states that file exists. So what if I don't have the file extension? Right now, we're just looking for a plain file that says secret message. And it states that file doesn't exist. So be sure to include the file extension if it has one. So what if I removed this file? So I'm going to delete it. And let's run this again. And it states that that file doesn't exist. So with the file constructor of our file object, when we list a file name, we're going to begin looking within our project folder as the initial directory. But what if a file is located someplace else within our computer, and not necessarily within the same project folder? What we're instead going to do is list the full file path within the constructor, plus the file name too. Well, here we are again, back in my desktop, so I would like to see or detect if my secret message is on my desktop, but I need to get the full file path. So I'm going to right click on my file, go to properties, and then copy this location. So this is the file path. Within the file constructor, I'm going to paste my file location plus the name of the file that I'm looking for. So if you have backslashes, make sure to include double backslashes because that's an escape sequence. On the other hand, forward slashes would work too. So just to demonstrate, let's switch these to one forward slash each. Kind of like that. All right, so let's run this again. If I have this file name at this file location, it's going to state that file exists or it doesn't exist if it's not there. And it states that file exists. So remember, if your file is within your project folder, you only need the file name. If it's anyplace else, you'll want to list the file path. So let's cover a few other useful methods of the file class. But for now, I'm going to move my secret message back into my project folder. And with the file path, I'm just going to list the file name. So it states that this file exists. Let's cover the getPath method. So I'm going to write this within a println statement. File.getPath. So the path is whatever you have listed within the constructor of the file class. So this is just going to display that. secretmessage.txt. Now, if you want the location of where this file is within your computer, that is the absolute path, and there is a separate function for that, file.getAbsolutePath, and this file of mine here is at this location within my computer. This is the full file path. The isFile method will return true or false depending if your file is in fact a file. So let's use the file.isFile method. So if this file is a file, it's going to return true, which it is. If you select a folder, well, this is going to be false then. So that's one way in which you can verify if a file is in fact a file and not a folder. We can also delete a file too. file.delete. So this is actually going to delete my file within my project folder, or I can set a file path if I would like to delete a file that's someplace else within my computer. So this is going to delete this file after running it. So I'm going to run this program. Well, what the heck? It appears that this file is still within my project folder, even though I called the delete function. Well, that's because we need to refresh this. So I'm going to right-click and click refresh, or you can type F5. So you can see that that file is no longer there, and if we were to run this program one more time, well, our file no longer exists, and it states that file doesn't exist. So those are just a few relevant methods. There's still way more methods out there, and you can always take a look through a few of these too, but I thought those are some of the more useful and pertinent ones to you. So that's everything you need to know to get started using files in Java. If you would like a copy of all of this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's how the file class works in Java.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.